Okay, now this is good target practice for finding where all the ones are at on the fretboard.
One,
Okay, notice there, what I did is, for part of that three count, is I changed to a different note to give it a little more less brittle, a little more activity, a little more herb, we might call it, a little more herb, seasoning, some homeopathic, right, to give it some homeopathics. Forget to follow the 1, 2, 3, 4, to always hit it, the target note, whenever it's due, and I just use what's called automatic substitution. In automatic substitution, every note substitutes, it works. I can substitute the 2 for the 1, for the one, a four for the one, a five for the one, a six target for the one, and a seven target for the one. All those targets I can substitute. It works every time. So the only thing that I'm focused on when I'm doing my solos is the rhythm of the music, or the count of the music. Or the chord change, the count, the rhythmic count, where the chord change is. And I find that that is somewhat automatic, you know, for our minds to follow. So all I do is I hold a note. Most of the time, this is what I find myself doing, is holding a note for the new count of the rhythm of the chord, the chord change. And the reason is because that held note becomes the target note, right? It's a lot easier for the ear and for us to visually to hold the note at first, until such time as we get skill at just hitting the target notes for fractions of a second. But that takes, wow, that takes real practice and quickness. So, what I do is I hold a note, and whatever note that is, it's either the real target note or it's a substitutionary target note. So what I would have to do is slow everything down so that I can count the note out. Because I'm still working on being more proficient. Substitutionary note calling. Target note calling substitutionary notes and going back to the original target note, the four note, and showing how they work. They still harmonize.